Kiva, like, uditam, visible. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki. Translation. As soon as the symptoms of his liberation were manifest, he saw a very beautiful airplane coming down from the sky, as if the brilliant full moon were coming down, illuminating all the 10 directions. Purport. There are different levels of acquired knowledge. Direct knowledge, knowledge received from authorities, transcendental knowledge, knowledge beyond the senses, and finally spiritual knowledge. When one surpasses the stage of acquiring knowledge, by the descending process, he is immediately situated on the transcendental platform. Dhruva Maharaj, being liberated from the material concept of life, was situated in transcendental knowledge and could perceive the presence of a transcendental airplane which was a brilliant as the full moonlight. This is not possible in the stages of direct or indirect perception of knowledge. Such knowledge is a special favor of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. One can, however, rise to this platform of knowledge by the gradual process of advancing in devotional service of Krishna consciousness. Om Agyanati Mirandasya Gyanam Gyanam Salakayat Saksurum Gitan Gyanatas Maisi Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Shimate Hanumat Prasak Swami Niti Namine Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Shimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Bancha Kalpa Taruvyacha Kripa Sindhu Vaevacha Patitanam Pavane Vyo Vaishnavevyo Namo Namaha Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay, so I wanted to share this verse because it's very nice when I heard about how this is Dhruva Maharaj. Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam is one story after another of Krishna devotees. Krishna devotees. And most of the time, the bodies are in Bhagavatam, and I guess here also in real, in these times, are facing a lot of problems. Yeah, facing problems and falling down and being confused and doing wrong things. But finally, by the mercy of Krishna and Krishna's devotees, one way or another, they can make arrangement and they have a happy ending usually in the stories. So this, who knows Dhruva Maharaj's story? Everybody knows Dhruva Maharaj's story? Yes? Who doesn't know who Dhruva Maharaj is? Never heard about Dhruva Maharaj? You have, okay. Yeah. Yeah, so as we know, Dhruva Maharaj, he had a very special father and a very special what do you call the second wife of it's not your mother but his stepmother. Okay, yeah. He had a very special stepmother. So this stepmother, because his father, the king, has several wives and several sons. So this stepmother of Dhruva Maharaj didn't want him to have quality time with his father. So Dhruva Maharaj, he saw his father playing with Dhruva's brother, with the king, the other king's son. And actually the king was in his throne and he was playing with his son and making nice things to him. Dhruva Maharaj was saying, "No, this is a cool thing, you know. My father is a cool guy, you know. He's playing with my brother. I will go. I want also some time with my father, like my brother, you know." But the king's wife, not Dhruva Maharaj's mother, but the other wife, he told the king, no, you will only play with my son. You are not allowed to play with Dhruva Maharaj. So Dhruva Maharaj was only 5 years old when he approached his father, you know, and he wanted his father to take him also in his lap and play. But the king, even though he really loved Dhruva Maharaj, but he was so dominated by his wife that he refused Dhruva. He said, no, there is no space for you here, you know, just play with your brother. So we can imagine how this heart can be this for a little 5 years old child, you know. Probably in these times he would be now on a psychiatrist or psychologist, you know, trying to fix Dhruva's feelings and emotions. That he ran to his mother's house, you know, and talking, no, this is happening to me, you know, daddy is not letting me play, you know, like with my other brother. What can I do, you know? And unfortunately, his mother was not able to give him a good solution. She said, yeah, this is happening, you know. Sometimes life looks like it's not balanced, you know. And I think you will not be able to have a proper relationship with your father. So this is life. What can we do? You know, but I really want to have this. So then on his way to his mother's house, he found his stepmother, the one who was actually forbidden. And he said, you will not get it. You will not be able to play with your father. Only my sons play with your father. So the only way you can play with your father is to die. To talk to God and ask Him to let you die and be take birth again from myself. And in this way, you will be able to. What a cruel stepmother! Hare Krishna. He was only 5 years old, you know, and she was telling, better you die and you take birth again if you want to play with your father. So he went crying to his mom and tell him, okay, you know, this is happening, what can I do, you know, and his mother was, okay, first of all, this stepmother, okay, she was so bad, you know, but was she so bad, really? No? She was giving some good advice to Dhruva. She was taking him to take shelter in Krishna. So sometimes we get advice from strange sources. You know, even some people that don't like us sometimes give us good advice. Anyway, mother confirmed stepmother's advice. Yes, I think it's very hard for you it would be almost impossible for you to have a proper relationship with your father, because your stepmother has a lot of power with him, and she does not want you to be there. So I think she's right. You know, the only way you can get what you want is to talk to Krishna, to God. You know. Then he asked, "Okay, what is God? I want to talk with God." You know, he was a determined boy, only 5 years old. I want to talk with God. What is God? You know, her mother said, I don't know. You know, I heard that the sages go to the forest and they find God in the forest. Okay, I'm going to talk with God. You know, mother was begging him, no, don't go, you are very little, only 5. You will not stop me, mom. I will go to the forest. You know, and then very determined, he went to the forest. 5 years old, very, very brave. And so he was so determined that by Krishna's arrangement, he found an amazing man in his way, or maybe in the forest already. He found Narada Muni. And Narada Muni was... Narada Muni's amazing personality also. He's all everywhere, you know. Almost in every story you read, he's Narada Muni coming or going. I really like how Prabhupada described Narada Muni many verses of Bhagavatam. I don't know in English, but in Spanish it's a transcendental cosmonauta, like a transcendental cosmic traveler, you know. And Narada Muni is taught Dhruva, yes, he gives him initiation, actually. He gives him initiation, gives him one mantra, he gives him basic instructions how to. Basically, it was a little slightly different, but basically he told him, okay, you wake up, Mangalarti, 16 good rounds, you know, Srimad Bhagavatam every day and chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Slightly different, but more or less like this. And Dhruva was very successfully and beautifully followed the instructions. So to make the story short, he became a very advanced body. And Supreme Personality of Godhead himself, he came to take to meet him. And when Dhruva saw the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the Supreme Personality of Godhead asked him, "What do you want from me? Why have you been praying so much?" And Dhruva basically told, "You know, I had some desires in my heart, but now that I saw you, I don't really want anything, you know." But he said, no, you wanted some things, yeah? You ask, you got it, you will have kingdoms and power, and your father finally will be proud of you. So, okay, he made different, he got success in life. Dhruva got many, many things, materially and spiritually in his life. There is an amazing, I told you I was crossing New Vrayamandala coming here, but we have this meeting also, you remember, in New Vrayamandala when we were there in the summer? And they were reading, because it was some months before, they were reading Dhruva Maharaj's pastime. And there is a part on the story where there is a big, big battle. Okay, who in this room know what Netflix is? Who knows? Okay. And who use Netflix sometimes? Sometimes. Okay. In Netflix we can find so many stories, no, like movies and things. Yeah. But and I have to admit that sometimes I take shelter in Netflix. Sometimes my mind is so, I need some spare time. Sometimes with my wife we watch some one movie, or but lately we don't use it that much because we start focusing again on Srimad Bhagavatam, and we realize that the stories that you can find in Srimad Bhagavatam you cannot find any place. It's amazing, really amazing. And people now is watching. I never watch that because I'm a kind of a scared guy. I don't like horror movies, but now some people are watching something called The Walking Dead. I don't know if you heard about that. It's a horrible stories about dead men that they kill other people. Anyway, but in summer we were reading this Dhruva Maharaj fighting in a battle. I don't know if you remember there when we were reading Srimad Bhagavatam in the farm in New Vrayamandala. And the description was amazing that in the middle of the battle, the trunk of bodies were falling down from the sky. You know, there was a battle, and trunk bodies were poof, and dead blood and excrement, and so many mockers were coming from the sky. It was really, really an amazing description. Yeah, that I can tell you will not find this in Netflix. You know, it's so amazing battle. You know, not even in Game of Thrones or anything like that. Yeah, it's Srimad Bhagavatam is much, much better. Let me tell you. Yeah. Unfortunately, there is no movies about Bhagavatam or modern ones. But I think we will develop some in the future. Yeah. So anyway, this verse that we are reading today is like the end of Dhruva Maharaj's story. You know, and we can see. Oh, we cannot see. But what we read was that finally one airplane with two Vishnu Dutas came to take Dhruva Maharaj.
Okay, like imagine that you do your service and you go to Sankirtan or you milk the cows, and at the end of your duty there in Brajadam, you milk the cows, or and then you get out of the barn and then you see an airplane coming from the sky. Probably a flower airplane. Yeah. Because Prabhupada also in Bhagavatam explains that in Kali Yuga we are making airplanes with iron, you know, but that's very, very bad quality of airplanes. You know, the cool people in the universe, they use flower airplanes, you know, and of course you utilize the airplanes, even though they clean it, they clean the airplanes, but they smell very bad, no? Everybody's in this close place, and the airplanes smell very, very bad if you try to realize it's not good. Even in some places in India, remember sometimes when they use the plane, and then sometimes the air assistants, they have like a spray. Have you ever happened to you? It's like, what is this? You know, it's very uncomfortable, you know? But Dhruva Maharaj, he got a flower airplane, you know, with two Vishnu Dutas, you know, and then they took him, and then he was flying from different parts of the universe, you know. It's an amazing, happy ending, okay? Next story in the Bhagavatam, you know which is the next story in the Bhagavatam after narrating Dhruva Maharaj? What's going on in Bhagavatam? What's the story? You are here on the sixth canto, I saw, so it's not that far away that you read fourth canto. What happened after Dhruva Maharaj takes the airplane and goes to the spiritual world or to his own planet? They ask Vidura about what happened with the descendants, with the family of Dhruva Maharaj. What happened? They are asking about, and what happened? And they narrate, okay, this king has six daughters and this and one and then and that. And then we get very soon. We get to the narration of the King Vena. Have you heard about King Vena? King Vena was a descendant of Dhruva Maharaj. And even though his family was a very nice family, a very nice king, very pious king, you know, and he was giving him a lot of love and education, and but Vena, I don't know what happened with him, but he was little, he was, you know, sometimes these things happen. Yes, first, when he got, because he was a king's son, he got an arrow and an O when he was very young. And first, he just put when you get usually this arrow present, they are not like, it's like an IKEA thing, you know, they are not. So he, first thing he do the string and everything, and then he went to the forest, and immediately he started killing all the animals in the forest, but with no restriction, you know, you know, old ones, ladies, pregnant animals, all everything. He was killing everything. You know, they were like, what happened to this boy? You know, and they were, they took him to a psychologist and everything. You know, and come on, you know. Take it easy, you know. We love you, you know. But what do you need, you know? Okay, so they decide. Okay, let's do one thing. We can ask with the families in the royalty in the kingdom and give him some good association, you know. So they take him into a youth mobility, you know, with the Erasmus class, and then he. So Vena was having good association and other friends. You know what he played? He killed all of them, you know, like a game, you know. He decided to kill all his friends, you know. So everybody was like, what is going on with this kid, you know? So his father tried so much to fix things with his son, but finally he was completely, I mean, lost, you know. His father was like, what can I do, you know? I use all my cards. So finally he disconnected from society. The king left home, left the kingdom. Everybody was asking, please don't go. But he said, you know, I cannot manage this situation. It's too much for me. So he went to the forest and disappeared. And then they had no king. So for some shortcomings of this of story, amazingly, King Vena, this little boy, was named the king of the kingdom. He was the king. Yeah, imagine him ruling. First thing he said, no more kirtan in this country, no more holy name, no more brahmanas, no more sacrifice, no more Sunday feast. No, he was very, very unreligious person. So finally, to make the story short, the brahmanas decide to kill, to make him disappear, and they didn't even did anything. They just chant some mantras and poof, King Bena, no more King Bena. Okay, he disappeared. Yeah, because the brahmanas were very, very upset with him. Okay, so this is just a short explanation what you can find in Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is an amazing source of stories, of adventures, of knowledge. Anything, any psychological perspective that you can find in the world, it's already explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So any problem you face in your life, you will find a solution in Srimad Bhagavatam. If one of these days you get out of your house or your temple and trunks of human bodies comes throwing from the sky, you can read Srimad Bhagavatam and you have the solution. How can you solve that? If your father or your mother don't treat you that nicely that you want, you have a solution in Srimad Bhagavatam. If your sons or daughters don't act properly, you have a solution in Srimad Bhagavatam. Everything. Some parts of Bhagavatam, there were some wives that they were not too satisfied with their husbands. Their husbands were too much focused in the temple activities. You know, they were chanting all the time, 64 rounds, 128 rounds, you know, and why is there? You never take me to the mall, you know, you never walk with me. So they were pushing a little bit, and they took shelter, and then the husband, he, I don't remember his name, he was a powerful yogi, he built for her a flying palace. You know, it was a big palace with gardens, you know, and this palace was a flying palace. So they were going from universe to universe, from party to party, you know, for thousands of years, you know. So even though if your husband is not treating you as nice as you want, you can find solutions in Srimad Bhagavatam. And if your wives are not making you happy, you can also find. So I highly recommend you to read Srimad Bhagavatam at least one hour every day. Why not? You know, you can go to the temple, and if you don't have a close by a temple, you can read with your family, and you can find a lot of information. And why is important to have information? It's important to have knowledge, because in life, as we see in Bhagavatam, all the devotees' life are different lives, and then you have to find always as a person, you will have to find to make decisions in your life, you know, because situations sometimes are a little bit struggling. So as we see in these two stories we were talking about, Dhruva's Maharaj's whereabouts were not that good, you know. His family was not really supportive. He was not going to get anything valuable from his father. I mean, the situation was not so nice for him. But he took good advantage, you know, and he was able to do a nice life and happy life, and to develop a nice life materially and spiritually. On the other hand, we see this Bena kid, you know, he had everything, nice father, nice kingdom, all anything he wants, the best teachers for him, but he didn't make the wisest decisions. He was not wise enough to take advantage. So life is not what you get, but what do you do with what you get. And if you are intelligent enough, you can be successful even when you don't have nothing. We have the Srila Prabhupada as an example. He came to the West and he had nothing. He was an old man, 70 years old. $5 in his pocket, you know, nothing. $5. And some books, you know. And then he made this amazing movement, you know, all around the world, 500 centers, you know, in almost 80 or 75 farms, rural communities all around the world, you know, and so on. And even in the material world, we have Steve Jobs and people like this. He was nothing, working in a garage, and he made it like an empire, you know. But what can we do? So it's nice that we have Srimad Bhagavatam, and sometimes we don't value that much. It happened in my life. For some periods of my life, I was not reading that much, and now I'm reading more. And even though I have very bad memory, and I always forget the names, and when I travel from one week to another, I don't read that much, and I forget what I was reading about. What is this story about? I have to go back some chapters to catch up sometimes. So I don't know if you have any question or comments or experience to share, maybe with Bhagavatam or nice stories. That was association is very important. I'm very glad being here because I said many times I love Slovenian Jatra. Nice deities, nice temple, nice devotees, holy food, Govindas. No, Lalita Govinda, pizza, ice cream, Padayatra, so many nice things. Even a Krishna consciousness dancing school. You know, what can we ask any more in a country? You know. So, only one thing I miss in Slovenia when I'm far away, I always miss you. One thing I miss, say, what would be a Slovenian Jatra if they would have a rural community, a farm? You know, that would be heaven in earth. You know, so I hope that sometime you can develop like a rural community. I was in 3 weeks ago. I was in Spain in my home, and I was like in Maya as usual. Kind of distracted, thinking about this event and buying tickets and so many things that are practical but not very useful sometimes. And then Mandragosh, is he a Mandragosh? No. Mandragosh was pushing me, you know, like, it's marathon time, you know, the bodies are distributing 10,000 books, you know, what are you doing? You are in Maya. Let's go Sankirtan. And I was like, oh, I have many things to do, Mandragos. I have to get flying tickets to go to Slovenia. Nah, you can do it in the night. Come on, go to Sankirtan. So he took me to Sankirtan, and it was a very nice day. Yeah, we distributed like 50 signs of self-realization. And I remember we stopped, we were doing together. And we stopped one father, and the father was quite old, like 60 or 70 years old, and the son maybe 50. And the father has a very, very strange, like, cross, you know, like gold cross, like this, very big, and, you know, with unbuttoned, and this, and all the hair, like, and then a big golden cross, you know, with, but it was the cross, and Jesus Christ also on the cross, you know, like, big, big. And his son was kind of strange guy with big glasses, you know, like this, and we offered them books, and then I was thinking in my mind, no way, you know, they are not taking, you know, but they said, well, we have to try. And then the son said, I like Srila Prabhupada books, you know. Yeah, Bhagavad Gita cities, yes. I read it, yeah, I have it, yeah. So, but you don't have signs of self-realization. No, I don't. Okay. So he said, okay, daddy, give him some donation. So daddy, and daddy. So it was very nice. And other day we went to where my father was, my father was born in Cuba, but where my father's father was born in a little village. And it was Saturday, they have like a market, and we were doing Sankirtan there. And then This is a small village, but these small villages have smaller villages around, you know, where very simple people, you know, taking care of cows and simple people. So this couple, you know, you can see clearly that they were like rural people, and in their 60s, and they asked them, excuse me, are you from here? This is the way I stop people. You are from here? Yes, yes. Okay, I want to give you this book. And then the lady was... And the man was like, but he was... And then the man looked the book and he get a smile and say, I love Srila Prabhupada books, you know? I said, and I was like, really? And then he was like, do you know which one I like the most? And what? And he thought, Bhagavad Gita it is, you know? I read it every day, you know? So. But at the end, I thought, do you have signs of civilization? No. Okay, you can have it. And he took the book. Yeah, he took the book. So, Sankirtan is an amazing activity, and I'm really happy. Okay, only Slovenian Jatra. Another thing I like of Slovenian Jatra. The day we come, the devotees told me, okay, we want to distribute 12,000 books and 20,000 cookies, you know, and we already distribute 10,000 books and 20,000 cookies. And oh, okay, nice. So what do Slovenians do when they distribute 20,000 cookies? Larita Govinda cooks another 20,000 cookies. I love this spirit. You know, I love it. It's very, very nice. So, yes, I think that for sure we are facing difficulties in this life because we are living in the material world. Once one reporter asked Srila Prabhupada, so because you live so transcendental life, you have no problems in your temples, no, in your communities. And Prabhupada said, of course we have problems. You know, we live in the material world, you know. Who has no problems in the material world? We will face problems in the material world. But if we take shelter in the okay, there is a magic formula to find happiness in this life. It's called FMP. Who knows what FMP knows? FMP, full morning program. Full morning program. Okay, that's the solution. So you wake up every day early in the morning. Mangal Arati, 16 good rounds, Srimad Bhagavatam, you know. And then you do whatever is your service, you know, for Krishna. You do this, also Prabhupada said, if you do full morning program, Krishna from your heart will let you know what's the next step, you know, what I have to do in life. Then you find your partners. You know, we are different. Not everybody is the same. Some devotees are in the sankirtan. Some devotees like cooking or taking care of the deities. In where I live now in Santander, very, very little devotees, you know. So sometimes Mangalarti, lately is only Mandragosa and myself, you know. And I'm very bad with Puyari activities. I barely can do an arti, you know. But what to say about doing an arti and chanting at the same time, you know? Samsara, dav, and how many, I get completely lost. But hopefully Mandragosa is a yogi, you know? He can do perfect arti, you know, very stylish, but at the same time he can follow. You know? So I chant samsara and then he follows. So, but whatever you have, you know, you only have two devotees, you can have full morning program with only two devotees. And then when you have two devotees, then you have three. Mata say, okay, Mandragosa and Jaramara are doing that. I wake up also, you know, so then we have three, you know, and then, but when you have so many devotees, or you live in Brajadam or Almik, or you are so fortunate to have so many devotees together, you can do strong full morning program. And then you can do whatever is best for you. And we will face problems for sure. But if we take shelter in the Maha Mantra, we take shelter in Srimad Bhagavatam, and we take shelter in the Srila Prabhupada books, for sure we will be successful, and for sure we will have a flower airplane catching us at some point. Yeah. Srila Prabhupada said that if you do what I teach you, and your sons do what I teach you, the sons of your sons will fly on magic carpets. So I want to see the sons of my sons flying on magic carpets, and I hope you help me. And if we distribute books and we distribute cookies and we open farms and we take care of the cows, the boys, the youth, we will see our descendants flying on magic carpets, as Srila Prabhupada said.
So thank you very much for your association. Thank you very much for reading Srimad Bhagavatam together. Ah, one question. Come in. Yes.
It's called also movie, Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, yeah, Hari Darshan, and Nimai of Nadia. In Srimad Bhagavatam have maybe 4 or 5 movie.
Okay.
Devotee like movie, this Hare Krishna movie.
Okay.
One collect 22 movie, 5, 6 is Srimad Bhagavatam.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we can make these conflicts. Yeah. Good. Thank you, yeah. Good idea. And Prabhupada movie, this last movie also very nice. Srila Prabhupada life will be a part of Srimad Bhagavatam in the future. You know, it will be indexed, like extra volume.
Hanuman movie, Ramayana.
Yeah, and then we have to make more even. Some devotees now are making movies, they are directors, and they are getting into the Krishna cartoons, who is Little Krishna. Gantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Slovenian Jatra ki, Book Distribution Marathon ki, Nitya Gaura Premanandi, Hari Hari Go. Hari Hari Go.